हाय, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर जितेंद्र हेगड़े, सीनियर लेक्चरर फ्रॉम प्रवीण पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग टेक्नोलॉजी, नौगर बाइंदर ईस्ट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न एप्लीकेशन ऑफ ग्रामर। इन इट वी विल डिस्कस टेंस। कोर्स आउटकम्स: आफ्टर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो, स्टूडेंट एबल टू लर्न और फॉर्मुलेट ग्रामेटिकली करेक्ट सेंटेंसेस। स्टूडेंट यूज करेक्ट फॉर्म ऑफ टेंस इन द गिवन सिचुएशन। दीज आर द लर्निंग आउटकम्स अचीव after watching this video. In our last three video, we discuss about the different kinds of verbs as well as present tense and past tense. And just like a present and past has a four aspect of simple, continuous and perfect, and perfect continuous, the same aspects or the state or the manner of completion action is in a future tense. In a future tense action, when you are dealing with the subject matter or incidents or action, that time action is not start, it will start in future. Okay. When you talk with the subject, the action will start in a future, means such a future incidents or action indicating by future tense. So will and shall indicating by future action or future aspects. Then simple future tense, in it the action is happen in a simply manner in a future tense. Will plus v1, shall plus v1 is used in this tense. Subject plus will shall plus v1 plus object plus full stop. So let us see the different kinds of examples and when such tense is used. To talk about the fact in future time which we cannot control, mean the future time we cannot control means uncontrolling time or action, such action indicating by simple future tense. My uncle will turn 40 this Sunday, means my uncle will turn 40 means 40 years is over, but we can't control the time, we can't stop the time. Okay. But such uncontrolling action or in future tense indicating by simple future tense, it will be holy in next week. Next week there will be holy, it will be holy. Okay. So such action indicating by simple present tense. To indicate an action that we think, expect, hope, believe will happen in future. We are expecting about the thing, it will be happen in future. I think Brazil will win World Cup. I am sure we will enjoy the game. I hope he will enjoy the picnic. Such are probabilities, such are the probable things, such are the possibilities. We are just assume about the incidents or action. Such types of assumption indicating by simple future tense. To indicate an action that we decide to do at the time of speaking. To indicate the action that we decide to do at the time of action. The task is not complete. I will complete it by evening. The task is not complete. I will complete it by evening. It is raining. I will take an umbrella. Means the action we decide to do at the time of speaking. Means just we are thinking about the rain, okay, there will be rain, that's why we are taking the umbrella. Such action is there, such prediction is there, we use simple future tense. Number 3, so next, future continuous tense. In it, the action will continue in future but incomplete in future also. When we are dealing with the action will progress at the time in future. For example, I suppose it will be raining when we start. I suppose it will be raining when we start. I mean, at the time of starting, there will be rain. Now, there is no rain, but when it will start, there will be rain. We just assume. This time tomorrow, I will be sitting on a beach in Singapore. At Singapore means we are sitting in a beach at Singapore, at this time. Today we are here, but we assume for tomorrow, indicating by future continuous tense. This tense, the structure is subject plus will be, shall be plus verb plus ing plus object. Means, for example, I will be sitting on a beach at Singapore. Future perfect tense. This tense indicating the action which will be start in the future and complete in the future. When you are dealing with a subject matter, the action won't start. You are just assume the action will start in future and complete in the future. To talk about the action will complete by the certain future time. For example, he will have left before you go to see him. By the end of this month, I will have worked here for 5 months. Means the completion of 5 months is completed in completion of 20 years in next July. So past perfect continuous tense is also there. Past perfect continuous tense. This tense is used. The action which will be started in the future, partly completed in the future, and remaining action is incomplete. Such action indicating by future perfect continuous tense. Means partly action is completed in the future and partly action is incomplete in the future, which will be in a progress over the period of time that we will end up in the future. Means the action in the progress when you are dealing with the action or subject matter, and it is partly completed and partly incomplete. For example, by next March we shall have living here for 4 years. Next March we shall have been living here 4 years. Means 4 years is completed in a next March to us of living in that particular place. I shall have been teaching for 20 years next July. For next July, 20 years will have been completed to me for teaching. Means such a future action, which will be start in a future, partly completed and partly incomplete future, indicating by the future perfect continuous tense. So, student, in future tense, the action which will be start in the future, now just we predict or just assume about that particular action. It has also the present, so it has also simple, continuous, perfect and perfect continuous aspect. Will and shall indicating such a future aspect. So these are the tenses, present, past and future. In future tense also has a 4 aspect. So I hope, student, you understood the topic very well. Thank you.